not least, we would like to invite Lois Leveen. I have friends.
How about this amazing musician?
Yeah.
So musicians sometimes play a scale to practice, and sometimes they play a song, and they always know whether they're playing a scale or playing a song. With writers, sometimes you think you're playing a song and it turns out you were just playing a scale. That is, you're writing something and it turned out to be an exercise. And sometimes you think you're doing an exercise and it turns out to actually be a piece, and that's really exciting. I Have Friends is actually an email that I started to write, and then I realized that it was a poem. In December of 2015, I was walking with my dear friend Maggie. We would walk every so often. And she told me that her partner, who had what they'd been experiencing as a chronic disease, had just been told by her specialist that it was time to start thinking about hospice. And Maggie was terrified. And I got to spend the next 18 months, year and a half, helping them through this process and learning and growing with them. So Judy had an extraordinarily long time on hospice, and Judy was a retired nurse. And she was really great at having grace and humor and acceptance and just the right amount of being pissed off often enough that we knew that she wasn't a saint. And it was an amazing time, and I learned a lot, and I really got to be supportive, especially for Maggie, as she was going through the hardest experience she had ever gone through. And Judy was dying over Memorial Day weekend, May of this year. And Maggie knew that there were some events that various people who were close to her had to go to out of town, and she said Judy would want everybody to go and dance and celebrate, go. So I got on a plane to go to Chicago, where the youngest child of one of my friends from college was being bar mitzvahed. And as the plane was landing at O'Hare, I said to my partner, I'm so glad to just have a reason to celebrate. And that evening, as the various friends from out of town had gathered, I learned that another friend from college who was there told me that he had just learned that he probably had cancer. And we spent a lot of time that weekend walking, getting to really have long talks that we would not have had if we didn't happen to be coming from two sides of the country to meet in the middle for this joyous occasion. And I have to say, this friend did not have grace. He did not have humor. He did not have acceptance. And I thought, oh, I'm so good at supporting somebody through difficult stuff. And he was much harder to support and has remained much harder to support. So I came home and I wanted to write him an email to sort of give both of us perspective and talk about how I wanted to be there for him. And it turns out this is what I wrote. I have friends. I have friends who underwent the most aggressive treatment and beat the odds on ovarian cancer. Underwent the most aggressive treatment and beat the odds on pancreatic cancer. Underwent the most aggressive treatment and upon recurrence, beat a retreat from medical intervention in favor of hot air balloon rides. I have friends who had the treatment, haven't had a recurrence, and feel emotionally and physically better than ever before. And others who had the treatment, haven't had a recurrence, and feel like before is a land they can never travel to again. I have friends who opted for wait and see, refused the transplant, declare stage four is the new stage two, just hope the drugs they're on now will keep them alive until something better comes along. Wish it were them instead of their kid. I have a friend who managed not to contract HIV until he was old enough and the drugs were good enough that it probably won't shorten life statistically. I have a friend who spent a year seeing doctors who couldn't figure out what was wrong until it was too late for first line, second line, or third line, anything to make a difference, and died at 34. I have one friend who chose death with dignity and died peacefully at home, and another who declined death with dignity and died peacefully at home. I have friends who have worrisome test results, surgery scheduled, another round of radiation. I have friends whom I love to whom I can offer only love. Thank you.
Those who don't know, we were able to read the stories and we selected a song that we wanted to make into a, a piece that we wanted to make into a song. And I picked this one, I Have Friends. The reason that I picked I Have Friends is because I just personally identified with that. I have friends who literally on that page, I think, of all that she named, there may be one that I don't know, someone who has been in that position. And again, the revelation of there are these diseases and these ailments, they affect not only you, but everyone around you. And as a community, we're all affected. If I lose my mother or a sister or a friend, my life is forever changed. And so, that's why I picked this song. It's a reminder that there are decisions that have to be made that affect our whole community, each and every one of us, in a great way. So thank you for your peace. Thank you for allowing me to do this. I have friends who opted to have the treatment, and I'm better than before. I have friends who also have the treatment and feel like before is a land they can never travel to again. Decline death with dignity.